go. Well, we've decided to go to Scotland and see if we can find Scottish things. We've stopped at the side of the road, because I found this. A great Scottish monument and a testament to the Scottish people. But also, we found this. Loch Ness. Now, Uppy's just fallen in.
Slightly.
His feet are wet, look.
Just slightly.
He went in, and I didn't have a camera ready.
It's rather slippery.
Yes, let's not slip in with the camera. That would be silly, wouldn't it? Loch Ness.
Photographic.
Nature man gets a call.
I haven't fetched the mobile telephone with us, have
I? No. It's tricky walking, isn't it? More to come, people. Well, guess what? Got to the campsite in Cannock. Paid and everything, right, nice and cheap. Lovely campsite. There it is. Lovely Cannock campsite. There's McDomsk. But I forgot my tent poles, so I've had to borrow some to make this makeshift style tent. Let's hope it's not windy tonight, because if it is, it'll get blown in. Look, as you see, it's totally all wrong. Tomsk's laughing.
It looks alright.
It looks alright from there. There's Tomsk's den. And there's the river.
Well, here we are. Halfway there. We've had a drink in the pub.
No, we're actually here.
We're
not halfway here, we're here.
Well, we are here, but...
Halfway.
Halfway to somewhere that's twice as far away as this is.
Halfway there?
Yeah. There don't seem to be any midges at the moment. We've got Mark's got some spray. Some shop at Spa Shop, remember it's Spa Shop? Stop bug off.
It's yellow. Insect repellent. One easy application, fits all. Very nice.
It does hum. It does hum some. Oh.
First afternoon here, first evening here. I think we'll partake in a couple of ales, a couple of drinks, maybe a bite to eat as well, I think.
We've already had, what you didn't know, Dewey or Paul, anybody who's watching this, that this campsite now has a cafe called...
I've forgotten the name.
Old Bogs or something.
Bog Boot.
Something like that. Bog Boots Cafe. And we had a lovely bacon and egg sandwich. But
fried egg sandwich, but the yolk was cooked to perfection.
But we've messed...
Alfie's sandwich bar had actually better take notes, because that is a sandwich to beat.
That is a good butty. Mm. I had joy ache after eating it. It was lovely. But we did meet our first character, let's say, in...
In what? In real time? Or
what's his name?
Oh, Old Father Time Boy.
Old Father Time Boar.
He's actually staying over
there. He's over there.
Better talk a bit quieter, else he might come over.
Yeah, he would not stop. He came... Oh, no, it's too long to explain. But he was boring us to death. And we're trying to eat the first food we've ate since 4:30 this morning. We got a bacon sandwich. And he was stood there talking to us all the way through it. He wouldn't shut up.
Well, actually, when we first met him earlier on, he was quite pleasant, weren't he? He was
yeah,
all right.
It was. He's here.
No, when we first met him, he was all right, weren't he? He was sort
of... Yeah,
he was just like an eccentric Scotsman, we thought. But now he just seems to be just an aggravating Scotsman. Everywhere you turn, he's there.
He said that it hates people and hates people's company. That's why he has a caravan, a camper van on his own, and he tours Scotland on his own, because he hates people. But he wouldn't leave us alone.
I'm a little bit worried, actually.
I were.
No, I still am.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
In case of this evening.
Well, he knows where we are. And he knows, I think, we were being a little bit sarcastic, I think, early. I think you knew quietly away. Well, so if you actually find this before you actually find us two, then you've got a lead to go on.
Yeah, he was over there.
And he's got long, white, straggly hair and a beard and a dog. He's quite thin.
You might also note that Mark is not wearing the traditional camping gear.
Not yet. No, not yet.
Not yet. He keeps putting it off.
No, I've put it off once.
He keeps putting it off.
But I'll learn, because I actually stepped into Loch Ness earlier today.
he got wet from Loch Ness.
I thought I only stuck 1 foot in, but actually I had 2 feet wet.
Yes.
I'll learn. Tomorrow will be the day. I'll have the combat attire on.
He's a no-rip.
Look good.
Just in case you're interested, the weird man is stopping, like you can see, but that camper van through there is his, and that's where he is.
We're pretty poorly in the picture of him, and it's Jackie's legs, that little man. Here, go. I mean, she's still got great legs, you know. And you think, she is just going to, men are just going to be attracted to her. So that she does anything, but much younger men, because she's 64, so practically all men are younger than her. Yeah. I mean, she goes in, she'll go into, say she's going over to her daughter's. So, going in the car, she'll stop off and go into a pub to have a lunch for herself. Always a glass of wine, isn't it? There's always some guy standing there. The waiter comes over and puts it down. She says, I didn't order that. That gentleman said. Mm. And she says, take it back. So the guy takes it back. I told you I didn't want that. Well, that gentleman sort of insists. She said, Right. So she picked it up, she walked over and the guy standing there. And she said, thanks very much, I didn't want it. And he goes, no. So he said, that's an opportunity to get.
There's a glass.
Well, it's there. Well, it's yours.
Yeah.
Well, as you may have noticed, our favourite mate, what's he called?
Leo.
Yeah, well, he's called Leo, but we call him
Old Father
Time Boar
Leo.
Old Father Time Boar Leo was just here, as you may have seen, talking to us again for about another, half an hour? An hour?
I'd say quite a long time, yeah, quite a long time.
Quite a long time.
I'd say between half an hour and an hour.
Yeah, definitely. And told us some more unamazing facts. Really?
We tried to secretly film him. He wasn't too keen, actually.
He wasn't keen at all,
no,
was he?
No, so that's why we tried to secretly film him. Didn't want to make him irate.
No. I even fed his dog water as well.
Because he did actually admit to having a split personality. And that's a little bit worrying, really. A little bit worrying. Because now he knows a little bit more about us.
Yeah, we know a little bit more about him as well.
He knows where we're sleeping.
And our tents are drastically apart.
He knows exactly what's in the car.
He does. But that'll be locked.
But
you may have noticed in this scene, after Old Father Time Boar Leo's gone, Mark's still donning his jeans of a blue variety.
Well, I'm not going to go and get changed while he's here talking, am I? So hang on, Leo, I'm just going to get these sexy pants on for you.
He's not really getting into the Scotland spirit. Apart from, he's getting into the Scotland wine, but he's not getting
into it's actually Bancroft Station.
Bancroft Station.
You mean to say I've not been drinking Bancroft?
Sure, it's Bancroft.
Oh, dear.
Station.
No, the army get-up gear will happen. It's just I'm not while I'm studying being talked to by some strange silver-haired buffoon. I'm not going to go into my tent and say, "Hang on, I'll just get changed and then come out dressed like you." He'll think we're like a bloody pair of weirdos.
Well, we are.
Well, we don't want to give him that impression, do we? But no, I'll get into the spirit. No, actually, since the last time. We've both got coats on.
Yeah, so I was going to mention that.
Yeah, so
it's
an hour,
a little bit colder.
It's an hour later, I think.
And well, it's time stamped anyway, so we should know.
Well, I approximate it's an hour.
I'd say about an hour, yeah. And it's gone a little bit colder. There's no wind at all.
And no sun now.
No sun, there's a bit of cloud.
A few midges, they've come out, I've noticed that.
There's one or two midges. I've drunk a couple, but they don't seem to be annoying us yet.
What, midges?
Yeah.
Have you?
I've actually drunk a couple of midges.
Have you?
Yeah. You're right.
I've swatted a couple.
A bit of calcium, a bit of iron.
Mm.
But yeah, so far so good. We've been up a very long time today so far, because we've been up since 4:30.
Well, actually, it is now over 12 hours we've been up.
Is it?
Over 12 hours.
I think we've done very well.
We've managed admirably, actually, for
I
a couple of...
I think we should get one of them barbecues on that bench. Let's get some sausages frying on it.
We might as well.
Yeah. Why not?
Yeah. Well, let's not bother going out for a meal tonight.
No, we'll stay here.
Yeah. Although, we
could
do it.
Do you concur?
We could do with some bread.
I could do
with
some bread. Right.
Cheers.
Let's go a bit closer. It's a bit blurred at distance.
With infrared?
Yes.
All snug, ready for an evening's drinking and barbecue.
We're having drinking and barbecue. That's our barbecue over there.
Barbecue burning.
Well, show you it.
In the distance. Walk this way. This took one spark.
Took one spark off a lighter.
And there we go.
It's not been touched since. We've not got anything on it yet, as such. But the food's there. Well, you can see it better under this light.
Oh, yeah.
We've got sausages.
Looks more appetising, doesn't it?
Tells me we've got bread.
Bread.
Knives and forks, plates.
Knives and forks.
No butter, though, or anything.
Plates. Sausages, even.
And sausages.
Very good.
Is that blinding you?
We've had quite an entertaining evening, haven't we, really?
Oh, yeah, very much.
What was the place called?
Slater's. Not with this afternoon.
We went there, but then we went to the other place, which is more friendly.
Yeah.
More friendly place.
Well, the Glen Africa Hotel, which is now closed down.
It's no longer a hotel, by the way. Just a friendly, homely pub with roaring coal fire, friendly bar staff, good cooked food, and romantic regulars who tend to like to spin you a yarn.
Very much, very much so.
One guy I thought he'd actually walked from... What's the name of the place where we are?
Cannock.
Cannock to Inverness. Every single day.
To go to work.
To go to work and back 25 miles.
And all he did was make beds.
Mm. Mm.
Up he keeps farting.
Not constantly. Maybe three every half an hour, I think.
It kills your night vision, this screen.
Huh?
Too bright.
About three in the last half hour.
They're kicking a hell about that tent with the sound of it. Well, a happy bunny. But meanwhile, we have some sausages on the go here. Look at them beauties. Uppy said they need about another 10 or 15 minutes yet.
At least.
They look good though, don't they?
Mmm.
Where's your head? Oh, there it is. We can't see anything here tonight. It's actually pitch black. Desert doesn't even know I'm pointing a camera at him.
They look good in HD, don't they?
It's not HD all at night.
No, I can see them in HD. I've got HD vision.
Where's me wine? Is that it?
Would you like me to pass you your wine, sir?
Do you know where it is?
Yeah.
Where?
Yeah.
Where?
Oh no, that's your torch, sorry. There.
Yeah, it's in my hand. But why is it clear? That's water. You fucking twat.
No, it's not water. It's wine. It's wine.
Why is it clear?
It's not clear. It's wine.
Why is that clear?
It's not clear. It may look clear.
That's weird, isn't it?
Yeah.
You can see through it with an infrared camera.
That means how shit it is. The wine, not the camera.
What?
It'll melt.
won't put it right over the fire, but you can certainly see through it, can't you? Right to the bottom of the cup.
It's,
aren't you?
X-ray infrared. Oh, that's amazing, yeah.
That's red wine. And you enjoy that is my red wine, isn't it?
And it's not as if there's hardly anything left in there.
No, it's half full. Wow. Red wine in infrared looks like water. That is red wine, I am not kidding you.
Loading. That's broken. Cold last night. Wasn't really warm at all. Rained as well, but I've not got wet. I need a wee.
You alive then, you horrible snoring creature? Say again.
The strange noises from your tent are quite hard to believe.
Are they louder than yours?
Mm. Oh, good, yeah.
It might have been him over there.
Maybe not. I don't know.
I hope I was snoring. That means I slept. Mm. Why is your head wet?
I just brushed it against here, probably. Huh. Did rain up, didn't it?
I heard a bit of rain at some point. Yeah, I'm totally dry though, are you?
Mm.
Good. Yeah. Quite cold, wasn't it?
I just had a bit on my face this morning, first thing in the morning.
Like a breeze?
Yeah.
I had that.
Yeah.
Like great cold dew seemed to be coming in. So I covered.
I'm going to close that up, this mesh thing.
Ah.
It's a bit of condensation now, though.
An old farmer's croft. Aye, this is the old haunted house. Full of sheep poo. It's an old thing, an old fireplace. Yes? And the stairs. Old tyre. Big turd. Lots of big turds. An old newspaper on the stairs. It's a page from a magazine.
beautiful day tonight.
Me?
Can't find a date on it. Here we are upstairs. Please, I haven't given any more clues. Looks pretty old. There's a sock there as well next to me. Oh, 1945. May 25th. 1945. 46, I think, sorry. Very old. I'll go and tell Mark, because he's here somewhere. I think he's outside. Where are you? Thank you.
quarter way through the whole day.
Yes, a quarter way through the full day.
Beauty. Everywhere.
All around us. Listen to that bird.
What sort of bird is that one, Grant?
It's a chuffinch.
A chuffinch?
Yeah.
Are they common round these parts?
Chuffinches are, yeah. Loads of them. Chuffed a bit, yeah.
They sound it.
Yeah.
Tommy.
electricity to charge up your camcorder. What might do the pechanga? Pechanga.
Thank you. It's an evening out after a few beers and a few Irish jigs, Scottish jigs. I'm just going back to the room for water.
What are you going for? You got one with you?
I did have, yeah.
What time do you think we should get out of here tomorrow?
Oh, really? I reckon.
Can I have your double bed then?
Yeah, if you like, yeah. Yeah, do
you want it? No, I'll sleep in this one.
Well, up to you.
No, we toss for it, Mark.
Yeah.
And that's where it goes.
Well, I'll probably come back to this anyway later. Because yeah. I need to go and pick up my clothes anyway. She's a big girl.
She is a big girl.
Yeah, big girl, but very pleasant and jolly. She's got bigger hearts as well.
He was pissed as I am.
Yes, very. Very, very. I don't think I'm going to fucking manage, actually, Graham.
How do you think you're going to get on?
I don't know. I'm going to give it my best shot. You got to, haven't you? You got to give it your best shot. We'll see.
Mark, go for it.
We'll see. We'll see anyway. Well, I've got the key. I've got the key and the room number. And the code. So.
That's hers.
That's hers, yeah.
Where is that? Is that in the other block?
The next building, yeah.
Right,
next,
yeah.
Next block, yeah.
Well, what? Do you want to take key with you or something? How are you going to get back in? Just bang on the door.
Right, yeah, I'll bang on the door tomorrow morning.
Bang on the door and I'll let you in.
I need to blow my nose anyway. God, I'm full of cold. Okay, no, we've got any tissue paper.
Yeah, it's bog roll somewhere.
Wee.
You alright?
Yeah, I'm fine. Right, I'm gonna go down there to the bog for a piss. I'm gonna go across to hers and then I'll see you in the morning. I'll knock on the door. Alright. See you in the morning. Adios, senor.
On my day, I live inside this place. Locked up inside my metal cage. Always tense and filled with rage. Above the concrete fields below. With you, I wanna go.
Music is my sanctuary. Music is my blanket. For a pad and a viral. Used to
stand in line, just so as I can sign my gyro. But now my ends are meeting in the best way that I know. Enemies that go boom, see the music I consume to escape the doom and gloom. All the beats and melodies that keep realities at bay. But what happened when the record done and start to fade away, fade away?
Alone within myself again, I try to veil away my pain. The dirty grey surrounding me round.
As I wonder how I keep from going under, I got trouble on my mind like my name was Chuck D. And like Marvin, yeah, it makes me wanna holler. But when the music hits me, I feel no pain. That's why I gotta put you on again and again. I take the needle off the techniques and put it in my vein. All my troubles get crushed as the rush hits my brain. And away